Okay, so yeah, just lay in a little of the jasmine in lightly, and we'll see how that works. All right, then, can't decide, sepia or pumpkin. Put them both in your hands. All right, so, okay, I'm going to try the pumpkin next and see how that. Ooh, it's much redder. It's much redder than what I used here. It's more like this, though, isn't it? That, all right, let's go to, let's, yeah. Can't decide what to do. I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to put sepia on the tracing paper next to you, and we're going to pick it up with the pumpkin to tone down that pumpkin a little bit and to work in some shadow. All right, so I'm going to start picking it up and kind of blending it in around the collar. I'm going to blend it into the darkest areas of the like the fold in the sleeve. Yeah, that tones it down a bit. That's good. Yeah, sepia on the, and you could, you know, we can go straight in with the sepia too, and some, in fact, have them both in your hand, because yeah, in those dark areas, that's, sepia is what's going to tone this down from being a little too bright, I think. So putting the sepia on the tracing paper, picking it up with the pumpkin and working it in. And I didn't really like leave much of the pure jasmine, just real light in some areas. Because like if you look at this reference right here, it might have a yellow light on it, but there's definitely something, you know, yellow highlight about it. All right, so I'm just going to keep working in. Just go right over the buttons. Don't worry about not covering those buttons up. Just go right in and just keep picking up the sepia and working it in with the pumpkin. And then we'll use the sepia to shade and tone it down. All right, I think it's going to work. I think it's working. So yeah, we're going to have lots of ink on there between the picking up the sepia with the pumpkin. So I'm just going to keep coloring, all right, you guys? And you can just keep looking up here. So I'm kind of just going around the collar, and then we'll figure out how to do that sheepskin collar as well. I do like the colors in this one. That wasn't what I had originally intended, but I do like it. All right, I'm just picking up sepia with the pumpkin, working it in. Coming into that darker area in the underneath the arm and the side of the body. Okay, wiggly lines. Keep it wiggly. It's kind of like the leather. All right, let me see. How can I explain this? So let's see. Oops. So let's see. I'm going to try to leave a little of the lighter highlight on the shoulder. Kind of work into the dark. But I'm trying to keep it into the elbow wiggly. Again, with the suede, we've got the generous bend wrinkles in the elbows. So let's see, even if we come in directly with the sepia, maybe we should. Okay, so here's, look up for a second, and what I'm doing in this area, I'm going to go ahead and go directly in with the sepia, try to get a little bit of definition. Now I'm going to quickly, though, put some sepia on the tracing paper, pick it up with the pumpkin, and then work it in. Maybe leaving a little bit of yellow over there on the side of the arm. Actually, I can even add a little bit more yellow there. Tone it down. Yeah, so if it's looking too pumpkin-y bright, you're drawing, the sepia will definitely tone it down. So this jacket is straighter. What was so nice about this one, it is it had some real nice, you know, hanging wrinkles to shade. This one, not so much. But it's, I guess it's more like this one over here, so this reference on the right-hand side. So that's okay. Just keep working in the sepia. Lots of ink, which is good because we haven't even used our pumpkin that much, so we probably have lots of ink. Lots of ink will help it blend. Oh, we forgot to do his face. We'll come back and do that. Okay, so I'm not quite finished working it yet. I'm still, there's any area that we think could use a little bit more yellow, you can kind of work the yellow back over top. Oh, I do like that. I do like the way that yellow looks when it's like, you know, the light's hitting it. Okay. Now I'm picking up more sepia with the pumpkin and going to work a little bit more shadow into it, into this arm area. Let's see. Darkening that shadow up in the area between the arm and the body. Maybe under the sleeve shadow, darken that up a little bit. If it's too dark, like it, I'm working the sepia and then right over top with the pumpkin to blend. I think I need a little bit more of that jasmine. Kind of, I'm looking over here now at this one, and there's like a little bit more yellow in this front area. A little bit more yellow. So you can see, you can work that yellow back over top, and it just kind of adds a little highlight and blends a little bit. How's it going? What do you think? Is it working for you? Okay, gonna come down this arm again and sepia in there, darkening it up. Putting a shadow back behind his hand, kind of working down around that edge, the rounded edge. Yeah, that looks good. Maybe round up the sleeve. Come back in here and a little bit more wiggly stuff happening there. Maybe a little bit more wiggly stuff there. Better. A little bit more shadow under the collar. I think that's all the marker I'm going to put on that. I'm going to give you guys a couple minutes to work on it. I'm going to turn the recorder off.